Hey everyone, JL Draco here. I am the co-founder and lead designer of Oneshi Press, an independent publishing company who is passionate about creating progressive, immersive, and gorgeous comics. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to take your camera and fly it around your comic book page, bringing it to life using Adobe After Effects. Stick with me. At the end of this tutorial, I'll show you the final product. So we are starting with a basic, just a 1080 HD TV 2997 composition. This is pretty standard, square pixels, but there's all different kinds of standards for different purposes. You might have a different one. There's a lot of presets and you can get pretty specific, but for now, we're just gonna stick to the HD TV. So we have this JPEG in here and it is right now just fit to the composition. We're gonna move about half a second in and put our first keyframes. So what you'll see is right now, I have these keyframes open. If they're not open, you can open all of your transform keyframes with this little drop-down arrow here, or with S and then Shift and P, you can open scale and position. For our purposes, we only need scale and position right now, so I'm gonna set those keyframes. I'm gonna move over about a quarter of a second and put in our first keyframes, which are gonna be to zoom right in on panel one. And if you hold down control and then click on the percent and drag left or right for in and out, it gives you just a little bit more control. It's easy to remember, control gives you control. If you want to zoom in and out tremendously, you hold down shift. We don't want that though. We want some fine-tuned control here. So anyway, we move forward, let's say, you know, a few seconds and put in some more hold keyframes. So now it doesn't do anything for a few seconds. And then we move forward maybe about half a second and we'll put in another set of keyframes and move over to the next panel that we want to be on. Cool, that's great. Now, we're moving from one panel to the next. Okay, that's cool. You know, it'd be cooler if it had a little bit more life to it. So let's take our first set of keyframes and copy them. Control C when they're selected. Move over here in the timeline about halfway and Control V for paste. So now let's see what happens. Whoa. So now we zoom out before panning over, right? Or midway through the pan. Gives it a lot more of a like intentional effect. So we're gonna do the same thing. Now what you'll see here is this last panel is actually quite a bit larger, but this is an interesting artistic decision. This panel is made up of several smaller panels. So what I'm gonna do is first bring us to the main panel. Put in our little zoom out. Cool, cool. So we're on the main panel now, and you can see the first part of the main panel is kinda nested in there. So I'm gonna zoom in on it pretty quickly. I'm not even gonna do the zoom out thing because this is all within one contained panel. So I'm gonna zoom in on it, center this first part, where he's talking about having been a dirty dancer. The tips were good, but not steady. Tip your dancers, folks. So we're gonna hold on for another couple seconds, and then just pan right over to the next part. Zoom out a little, because this drawing's a little bigger. We don't wanna cut off his feet, his pretty little feet. He's supplemented by wrestling chickens. And again, hold for a couple seconds, pan up. You can zoom in a little bit because this drawing's a little smaller. Painting hedges, again, move over a couple seconds. And piloting mechs. We want to show as much of that mech as possible, so let's zoom out a bit. That's cool. and then move over. So give them time to say nothing too unusual until one day, and then hold and return to that full page. So, bam. Now, we zoom out on our timeline. You can use this to zoom in and out and grab our work area and close it off like a half a second after our last keyframe. Now you'll want to make sure that this little checkbox down here is selected on, and what that's going to do is it's going to give you motion blur so that while you're zooming in and out, it's just going to give it that little extra bit of life. And that's really important. It's very, very cool. So let's see what that looks like. Bam. All right, let's watch the whole thing.
Well, Mr. Guy, no one else has applied, so I guess you got yourself a job.
Excellent, thanks. You won't be disappointed.
Sure, so how'd you become a hunter anyway?
Oh, cool story. I think it's best told with an old school flashback. Do you mind?
I guess we could spare a few pages for a flashback.
Let's use narration boxes! Memory vortexes are really loud!
I didn't always look like this. I used to be a dirty dancer. Chips were good, but not steady. I supplemented by wrestling chickens, painting hedges, piloting mechs.
Nothing too unusual until this one day. So hopefully with that bit of insight, you'll be able to create your own video panning across your stunning, gorgeous comic book pages. And you know what? If it is too difficult, we've included an affiliate link to Fiverr in the About section. And I actually get paid every time someone signs up to Fiverr using that link. So please check Fiverr and see if someone can do this for you.
All right, friends, stay awesome.